Yeah, this is Oscar from Blue Pride Kennels, a proud member of the Elite Edge. I've been in the bully game for about 15 years. What got me started is just pretty much, man, the love of the dogs. I've had them just about all my life, was raised with them. And well, right now, the style of dog that I'm breeding is pretty much bully, you know what I mean? The bully is the better for me. Try to keep it semi-correct, you know? Yeah, my foundation male has been Chief. I mean, we took his daughters and bred them to Easy Rider, and that's what he, you know, that's what gave us the style of dog that everybody's loving out there right now, you know? To me, Bully is a dog that is just impressive, man. It's got everything, you know what I mean? A showstopper, that's what a Bully is to me. The bloodlines that I mainly deal with is razor's edge, man, but I'm not afraid to mess with anything else, man. I pretty much deal with every single blood, you know? It really doesn't matter to me, you know? I can make it work with any blood. You know what, Lolo, he's probably my smallest, my shortest bully right now. Mainly razor's edge, you know what I mean, with some Norwood in there. He's probably about 45 to 50 pounds, you know, about 14 inches tall. Got a real nice defined head, you know, something that I really like about him. But he's becoming to be one of my best producers. I mean, he got tons of kids out there, man, that are just killing it, you know? I mean, pretty soon I'll have my website up and people will be able to see what I've produced, you know? Especially what he has done. And by the way, Tommy's his son, you know? Tommy Guns, he's probably about 85 to 90 pounds. You know, he's only a youngster. He's only about a year old. He just hit a year. And he got a lot more to go. So if people like him now, they're gonna love him in 6 months from now, you know what I mean? He hasn't hit maturity yet. Hustler's probably one of my favorite dogs in my yard. He's like my own personal dog. Hustler's probably about 90 pounds. He's about 18 inches tall. I mean, I love the guy. He's got a hell of an attitude, a lot of drive. It's really what I like in a dog, you know what I mean? But I was willing to please, you know? I mean, the guy could hit the pole. He could chase balls. I mean, name it, he'll do it, you know what I mean? I will be using him a lot more in the future, kind of like just for me. You know, he's got a lot of good productions out there. If people look into it, you'll be able to see, man. But the guy is just, you know, he's really what I look for in a dog. And this is my main producer, Easy Rider. He's probably about 85 pounds. I mean, honestly, a lot of people consider him to be one of the best producers of all time. And it's not just me saying it, you know, if you do the research, man, you'll see all his kids. A lot of his kids are being used now as Kennel's main studs, you know what I mean? Some of his main studs, it's Playboy from Long Beach, LB Finest. You got Easy Does It from Vicious Kennels. You got Bazooka from Next Round. You got Mission from Legion of Doom. You got Fonzie from Zen Styles. You got my boy Lolo. And you got Curly from Packing Heat Kennels. Banzas. I mean, there's just tons of them, man. If you know, do the research. Another big name out there is Omen. We got Omen. We got Trunks. I mean, just too many to name right now, you know. But I couldn't be happier with him, man. I mean, he's done a whole lot for me and the dog game. So that's it, man. You guys see my yard, see my dogs. Thanks for stopping by and checking us out. Just want to send out a special shout out to all my EE family. You know what I mean? Much love to all you.
What's up? This is Pratt's. Welcome to Pratt's Pits. Come on in. Let me show you some of my dogs and show you what I'm working with. Some of my heavy hitters and up and comers and all that good stuff. First, we have King Kamali, 2008 Nationals winner, ABKC. My pride and joy. He was born and raised right here. He's off a thing in Nikita. He's a medium-sized dog, 18 inches, 24 and a half inch head, about 87 pounds. He has it all. He's a complete package dog. That's why I love him. His head's about 24 and a half inches. I've even measured it at full weight. Sometimes it can even get close to 25, but it usually hangs around 24, 24 and a half. I think a dog's head measurement can go up and down with his weight and how much water is holding and stuff like that. So his neck is probably about 22 and a half inches, which is bigger than a lot of dogs' head. That's just something that most of my dogs have pretty nice neck development. I don't know if it's because I feed them with the food bowl raised or what, but most of my dogs come out with pretty good neck development. But yeah, his is extra, extra thick. Okay. Next, we're gonna come up to the old man. He's actually retired, semi-retired. Bane, he's off of the very first Dozing Days of Breeding. So he's about 9 years old, still looking spry. He's semi-retired. I'm gonna try to collect on him. And I still got stuff in store for this boy. When I get the right females, I'm gonna bring them back. But as of right now, he's just chilling and still looking good for 9 years old. This is my man Nemesis right here, 6 years old. Probably the dog that put me on the map back when big dogs were popular and big bone and stuff like that. But he's still gonna be incorporated heavily here at Pratt's Pits because you gotta use them big dogs to get that big dog bone on them short compact frames. So right now I'm just down getting ready to go full blast with him. He's a beautiful dog, tight skin. Good angulation, straight feet, good drive, good temperament. He's just an all-around good dog, so I gotta keep him in my program. So he's gonna be the mainstay, really. My man Nemesis. This is my man Sway, one of my up-and-comers. He's off King Kamali and Belicious. Belicious is a Nemesis daughter. She's I keep her in the house. You'll be seeing her later. He's almost 7 months, already got a head over 20 inches, good size, probably about 65 pounds right now, still got a lot of filling out to do, but I think he's going to be ready to do some damage in the show ring. At about 2 years old, he should be right. Nikki, this is my foundation female right here. She's Nikita, she's Daz and Jules. And she's like one of my watchdogs. She's a real good watchdog. She's also King Kamali's mom. I bred her the thing to produce King. And she put down for me each and every time. You know what I mean? She doesn't throw any faults. I bred her three times, no kinks, no overbites. None of that. So she's really my when somebody say a foundation bitch, this is my foundation bitch right here. I have three more other dogs that I could show you. Two I keep in the house, Belicious and Mr. Tibbs, one of my youngest prospects. And I also have Kylan. She's in heat, so I keep her separate from my males. So let's go check them out.
All right, this is Belicious.
Yeah, this is Belicious and Mr. Tibbs. It's probably been about 12 years. Yeah. Been doing it for about 12 years. Getting into the bully game, it wasn't something that I set out to do. It kind of just happened. I grew up in Washington, D.C., and I grew up around an old man that was in the dogs, and he bought a breeding pair of pit bulls from out the back of one of those magazines, and he got them shipped to him. And I used to stop past his house and talk to him every day and look at those dogs and just, you know, growing up liking athletics and being an athlete, and of course you kind of want your dog to reflect you. As soon as I got married and got my house, the next thing I did was bought two dogs, but not to breed, they were just pets. And actually my man Albert from Diego Kennels, I worked with him, and he bought two dogs and a breeding pair, and that's kind of like how I got into it through him. So when I got into this, they weren't as extreme as you see some of the dogs are now. So back then it was more like a AKC and UKC show dog with just a little more substance, bone, and head on them, but with the same correct conformation and stuff like that. So to me, that's kind of what I'm holding to even to this day, is that type of bully. Today you see a little more extreme style dogs, smaller dogs, more bulldogish traits coming out, you know, different strokes for different folks. But I try not to vary too much off of what got me into doing this in the first place, which is the dogs like Cairo and Knuckles and stuff like that. This is a hobby to me, so it's really hard for me to say it's like a program, you know what I mean? It's a hobby that I'm kind of grooming into a program. I don't think it's there yet. Got a lot of work to do. It started off like a hobby to me, and I'm taking it real slow. Most of my breeding have been for myself to try to get my own yard together, and that's what I'm still in the process of doing. Eventually I would like to, you know, show a little bit more, maybe get dogs canine good citizen and start gearing more towards training and actually doing stuff with my dogs as opposed to just breeding for looks. So it's still a work in progress. So right now, it's just a hobby, you know what I mean? I enjoy the dogs, I love the dogs, and it's just part of me, so that's what I do. This is Pratt Pitt signing off. Thank y'all for coming out, and if y'all need to see all my upcoming stuff, you can check out my website at www.prattspitts.com.
Yo, what's up? This is Dave Wilson, owner, founder, Razor's Edge, one of the owners of Atomic Dog Magazine, founder of the ABKC, Elite Edge, and that's who I am, Razor's Edge. See, Razor's Edge been around 19 years this year, so I started with game dogs and then got into some show dogs, Amstaffs, Pits. I started blending like the Amstaffs and the Pits together probably back in the early 90s, maybe 1990, I think is when I really started doing it. And, you know, breeding for a bigger dog, you know, like a heavier bone, blacker head kind of dog, you know, a bigger dog. And started competing in UKC and showing the dogs and did real well early on in the UKC. I was marketing my dogs as being bullier than the average dog. And what I mean by bullier, you gotta understand, is that a staff came from a pit bull. That's what it is, point blank, is they took the pit bull and they bred it for show purposes and created the Amstaff. So it is, in essence, still the same ancestry as a pit bull. No other breeds were mixed in. It was just bred in a different direction. But the original pit bulls, they don't really know what they're from, but they're from a bulldog type and a terrier type. That's what they put together. They put the bulldog in there for the power, for the stability, the terrier, for the tenacity. Early on, when we were advertising our dogs, I liked the dog with a little more bone, you know, a little more body mass, a little more head, not just your average, you know, something that's a little more physically impressive looking, more powerful looking, you know, just carrying a little extra size to it. So we started using the term bully, like saying, you know, the dog was bullier than the average dog. Like one of our, you know, quotes that we use was putting the bull back in terrier, you know, not meaning putting a bulldog in there, but just meaning breeding for the bullier traits that stem from the bulldog type dog. It's all in the dog. So it's more a substance terminology. It doesn't necessarily mean shorter dogs. It doesn't necessarily mean fat dogs. It just means dogs carrying a little more substance, a little more girth, you know, things like that. So that's where the word bully stem from. And I started selling dogs out to LA. And when my lines branched out to LA, probably in the late 90s, it took off, man. It like in a direction that I had never anticipated it taking off. I said out here, they had dogs like mine too that weren't Razor's Edge. They had bully dogs, gray line, Gotti line, a couple other bloodlines out here. So by us linking up together, Razor's Edge, gray line, Gotti line, especially it really happened out here on the west side, you know, that's what really started this whole bully movement. And that's where it all began and why it began. So I don't say I started it myself, but we were a big, very influential part of, you know, the entire bully movement, Razor's Edge was. And to be honest with you, if it didn't hit LA and Cali the way that it did, it wouldn't have taken off the way it did. So I show a lot of respect to the West Coast, because it was out here that I realized the issues that were going on and the way people were being treated, especially over race or their appearance and things like that. And, you know, it wasn't right. I actually came out here one time to show dogs in the UKC. And when I came out here, a bunch of people came over to meet me and brought their dogs, Razor's Edge dogs, Gotti dogs, you mean a lot of dogs, you know. And they came and hung out with us at the show, and the UKC people at the show kind of like turned their nose up at it, but I didn't think too much of it, you know. Then I came back another time later on, and a lot of guys were hanging out at the park. On the show was on one side, they was on the opposite end of the park, you know. And the people at the show were upset that they were there with their dogs. And I think, you know, they were upset by the crowd and the way people looked and stuff. So they ended up calling the police and escorting everybody who wasn't part of the UKC out of there, even though they was at a public park, you know. So that really offended me, you know, when I saw that. And when I seen that go down, I was like, you know what, this is not right. To see people treated like this, and all they're doing is trying to do something positive with their dogs. So that's kind of how we started forming this thing. And we formed the ABKC, which is the Registry for the American Bully. And this movement kind of started because of that incident, you know. I mean, out here on the West Side, they always doing their barbecues, they're doing their little things like that. We were doing that our way. But by us teaming up together and making a place for ourselves, that's what really started this whole bully movement.
Come here, you little motherfuckers. Get low.
How you doing? This is Joe from Squire's Bullies.
This is Squire from Squire Brewery too.
Basically, the main dogs that we have here are, you know, extreme. You know, that's what we're known for. You know, most compact, more wider chest, you know, more shoulders than your normal bully. 2004 is basically when we started doing the extreme bully thing, you know. Started off with Bismarcky, you know, started getting a couple females, different bloodlines, you know, that consist Razor Edge, you know, the little bit of, you know, the gray line Gotti, you know. Basically, we studied the bloodlines to produce, you know, short, compact, no muzzle, short back, An extreme look. Yeah. Bismarcky, it's out of TI and Banji. You know, the main focus is just 100% razor edge. You know, if we throw a little mix and guideline, we just produce extreme freaks, you know? These extreme bullies. A lot of people have seen what he's produced with Lalo daughters, you know, with Legend daughter. Yep. So it's just pups that you never seen before, you know, the look they never seen. You know, we just focus on the female. We also, you know, want to make sure the right females go to Bismarcky and the other males here, you know, to produce the extreme look. Basically, we also have his brother Humpty and his half brother Booyah. You know, that's top producing female right now, Banji. And she's produced other extreme dogs for us also. You know, rest in peace Bronco. People knew him for a little bit. And also we got, she also produced that litter with Bismarcky, Humpty, Dougie Fresh. That litter was just consistent and just, you know, full of extreme bullies right there. And then also she, you know, also produced our up and coming stud, Booyah, out of Pee Wee and Banji. He's also, you know, real extreme, something that people don't see all the time. So, you know, and we're glad to have these dogs out here in the West Coast. Everyone's just calling off the hook, you know. We got plenty of years to go. Bismarcky, you know, just barely turned two. His offspring's growing up. A lot of people are gonna be seeing a lot of him soon and years to come. So he's gonna be, you know, it's the start of a new legend right there. So, you know, anyone, you know, wants to get towards the extreme bully, you know where to go. Squires Bullies right here. You know, we love, you know, the bully world. We love going to the shows. You're gonna be seeing us a lot more now in shows. You know, we love the, you know, the people. They treat us well, we treat them well. And basically, you know, the Squires Bullies here to stay. Anyone, you know, has any questions, you're welcome to call us anytime, you know. We're good people, man. We love, you know, talking about bullies all day, every day. So, you know, that's what we do. Basically, the future for, you know, Squire is just improving the extreme bully, improving the bully, you know, showing the positive, you know, of the bully, you know, for years to come.
What's cracking, Bully Badass? This is T-Bone, Game Over Bullies, one of the founders of the 91 West Empire. I'm going to show you a little bit what we're working with on this side of town in Compton. Basically, we based our yard off of a lot of the Moomoo blood. You know, we like that bone, that girt, you know. We like that compact. We like tall dogs, short dogs, any kind of dogs, nice headpiece. We got them all over here at the 91 West. And, you know, starting off with one of my females that I like. Her name is Seduction. She's off of Prince Gotti bred to his mama, Queen Lunatic. Prince Gotti's off of One Drop and Queen Lunatic, and Queen Lunatic's off of Goliath Moomoo. This is another dog that I'm trying to show you right here. His name is Stax. He's off of Boogie to Queen Lunatic. Boogie's off of Monster Lefty. Queen Lunatic's off of Goliath Moomoo. This is another dog that I want to show you guys. Her name is Baby Lunatic. She's one of the little shortest Golden Boy daughters out here right now. One of the most beautiful females that Golden Boy's produced. Her name is Baby Lunatic, and she's off of Golden Boy bred back to his mom, Queen Lunatic. As you can see, I like a lot of that Queen Lunatic blood. You know, if it keeps spitting, if it's throwing, I say keep the model. So Golden Boy's off of Kingdom, Queen Lunatic, and Queen Lunatic's off of Goliath Moomoo, which is Legend's Little Mate's sister, Queen Lunatic. Another male that I want to show you, his name is Capone. He's 100% out of Ed Shepherd's yard. He's off of Otto, bred to Kasia. He grandson off of Boogie. He's a nice male, nice, you know, nice head all around. One of the best Otto sons out there right now. This is another female that I want to show you guys. Her name is Golden Angel. She's off of Golden Boy. Golden Boy was bred to Blue Angel. Blue Angel's off of Goliath Moomoo, which is Legend's Little Mate's sister. And you know, Golden Boy is off of Kingdom to Queen Lunatic. This is one of the boys that I like right now, one of the upcoming studs that's going to be hitting for the 2010. His name is Jigsaw. Picked him up from Houston, Texas. You know, shout out to Adrian. Thanks, Adrian, you know, letting me pick up this boy. He's off of Kryptonite. Kryptonite's Little Mate Brothers to Kingdom and Prince Spade. And bred to Nana. Nana's off of Pesado Gabbana, and Kryptonite's off of King Spade, Queen of Hearts. All right, well, thank you guys for coming out here, City of Compton. Visit the Game Over Camp, 91 West Empire. And, you know, thanks Bully Badass for coming down and visit us over here. And you see what we're working with over here on this side of town. We keep it consistent. That Moo Moo Blood, Gotti Line all day. Shout out to Joe from 91 West. Shout out to CeeLo's, Carlos, Notorious Kennels. And shout out to my boy Jimmy Cofal, Downtown Kennels.
My name is Memo from the Double S Kennels. We're a small kennel out of Los Angeles, California. We're also the makers of the Atomic Dog magazine. Atomic Dog magazine is the first ever lifestyle dog magazine of its kind. It caters to the most discriminated dogs in the world, which are the bully breed dogs. The American Pit Bull Terrier is one of the most discriminated dogs in the world. These dogs we no longer call pit bulls, we call them American bullies. These dogs aren't being bred to be pit fighters, they're being bred to be loyal companions and to compete in the ring and confirmation shows and show themselves like their classic cars. Us, Atomic Dog, would we go out there and show the world exactly the whole lifestyle and the whole bully movement. You got tons and tons of people from all over the world and from different races, different likes of music, people that don't even wear the same type of clothes, always together, whether it's in here in Los Angeles or in Alabama or you name it, Thailand. I mean, people are just coming together in numbers, showing support for these dogs and showing them. These are family members that have been hidden behind doors for a long time because of the negativity behind the breed. But now there's venues for them, so now they come out, they're out the backyards, they're winning trophies, and they found a newer purpose in life. Through the magazine, we've been able to make it cool in the hood, you know, to spay and neuter and not breed, as we call, bullshit to bullshit, and to take care of a dog. The number one thing that we've accomplished in mostly almost all the hoods in America, real tough, was the dog fighting issue. It's a no-no to fight a dog in the hood now, and it's become cool now not to fight dogs. You know, problems that they've had for decades are being solved now because, you know, these dogs have a venue for themselves now. You know, man, they're being shown and through clubs and you name it, man. Everybody in the world that owns them embraces them now. 90% of the people that own these dogs will never ever fight their dogs. These dogs at the beginning, first of all, even when they were bred to be ultimate warriors, they were bred never to harm a human hand in the heat of battle. Nor referee, nor dog handlers were getting bit in the ring. Why? Because the dog originally was bred not to bite a human. And so the success of the bully breed was that original trait that the original trait that they have is that now they're breeding the dogs to really not bite humans and to just be mellow and they're getting the non-aggressive dogs and they're breeding them with the non-aggressive dogs and the metabolism of the dogs have slowed down, so that's why you see the dogs have gotten bigger. You know, these dogs aren't being made anymore to go 10 hours in a ring anymore, you know what I mean? So that's why when you hear, oh, that's not a pit bull or whatever, you know what I mean? Well, yeah, it's not a pit bull anymore because this dog isn't being bred to be in a pit anymore. So the name American Pit Bull Terrier to us in the pit bull world has become a taint on our pedigree, you know what I mean, of these dogs' pedigrees. So that's why they call them the American Bullies. There's tons of breeders all over the world right now doing immaculate jobs in their breeding programs from all over the world, man. People are really doing great jobs and breeding great dogs to great dogs, great temperament dogs to great temperament dogs, and a lot of people stepped it up, which is one of the things that we've made cool through our media, through Atomic Dog Magazine, through the American Bully Show, the TV show we have, is to teach people it's cool, you know, it's cool to say, you know what, you know, if you don't like a dog and don't like the way it looks and you don't think it's gonna compliment your dog, then you shouldn't be doing the breeding. because that's when you get all these problems of dogs that people nobody wants. So eventually those dogs leak onto the streets and create more problems and saturate the shelters. And that's one thing, big part of what we're doing as the bully movement is to solve those problems. And there's tons of dogs being murdered in these shelters, and we're trying to bring those numbers down. This your boy Memo from Atomic Dog Magazine, the first ever lifestyle dog magazine of its kind, right here representing for the American Bully Show and the original Double SS, the world famous Double SSS.
It turned out to be a really great day. The weather was nice. It was supposed to rain this morning. We had a little overcast, but it's clear, kind of a little cloudy. Man, a great turnout, great people. A lot of different kennels, new people that have been doing it for a while. Man, it was a great turnout. Barbecues going, just a lot of, you know, a lot of nice dogs, good people. And if anybody's interested in shows or events and want to get into this, you can go to bullyshows.com and find your local event. Or if you're wanting to be a show host or get involved with the ABKC, you can go on bullyshows.com or even abkcdogs.org, you know, and check out the site and get involved, you know.
How you doing? This is Joe from Squire's Bullies.
This is Clive from Clive Brewery too.
Basically the main dogs that we have here are, you know, extreme. You know, that's what we're known for. You know, most compact, more wider chest, you know, more shoulders than your normal bully. 2004 is basically when we started doing the extreme bully thing, you know. Started off with Bismarcky, you know, started getting a couple females, different bloodlines, you know, that consist Razor Edge, you know, the little bit of, you know, the Gray Line Gotti, you know. Basically, we studied the bloodlines to produce, you know, short, compact, no muzzle, short back.
An
extreme look. Yeah. Bismarcky, it's out of TI and Banji. You know, the main focus is just 100% Razor Edge. You know, if we throw a little mix and guiding line, we just produce extreme freaks, you know, these extreme bullies. A lot of people have seen what he's produced with Lalo daughters, you know, with basically Legend daughter. Yep. So it's just pups that you never seen before, you know, the look they never seen. You know, we just focus on the female. We also, you know, want to make sure the right females go to Bismarcky and the other males here, you know, to produce the extreme look. Basically, we also have his brother, Humpty, and his half-brother, Booyah. You know, that's the top producing female right now, Banji. And she's produced other extreme dogs for us also. You know, rest in peace, Bronco. People knew him for a little bit. And also we got, she also produced that litter with Bismarcky, Humpty, Dougie Fresh. That litter was just consistent and just, you know, full of extreme bullies right there. And then also she, you know, also produced our up-and-coming stud, Booyah, out of Pee Wee and Banji. He's also, you know, real extreme, something that people don't see all the time. So, you know, and we're glad to have these dogs out here in the West Coast. Everyone's just calling off the hook, you know. We got plenty of years to go. Bismarck, you know, just barely turned two. His offspring's growing up. A lot of people are gonna be seeing a lot of him soon and years to come. So he's gonna be, you know, it's the start of a new legend right there. So, you know, anyone, you know, wants to get towards the extreme bully, you know where to go. Squares Bullies right here. You know, we love, you know, the bully world. We love going to the shows. You're gonna be seeing us a lot more now in shows. You know, we love the, you know, the people. They treat us well, we treat them well. And basically, you know, the Squares Bully is here to stay. Anyone, you know, has any questions, you're welcome to call us anytime. You know, we're good people, man. We love, you know, talking about bullies all day, every day. So, you know, that's what we do. And basically, the future for, you know, Squares is just improving the extreme bully, improving the bully, you know, showing the positive, you know, of the bully, you know, for years to come.
I don't know what to do. Congratulations, you got a grand champion winner.
Come on, get
right from the
seat.
We got a winner!
How's it going? I'm Jason from Monspit Kennels. The philosophy here at Monspit Kennels to make a beautiful dog, unique, exotic looks and colors on pit bulls. American bully dogs, I should call them, because we're slowly changing the breed. Exotically and structurally, I'm talking about an all-around bully dog. Neck just is extremely crazy. Chest to go with it, and bone that, you know, just sets itself apart from other dogs. I breed Gotti Line dogs. I started my old branch of dogs off the Gotti Line with my dog Don Julio. I've made some Don dogs, which I've been pushing out, which is also called Don Line. Just a different style Gotti Line dog. Just to represent my stud, Don Julio, he's throwing a different style dog. Like I said, a really extreme bully, clean look. Don Julio, what he is, he's a different style dog, man. Since he was a baby, he was always a girthy little pup, and knew right away when I got him from North County Gotti Line's yard, he was going to be something special. And as he's growing with such a massive chest, massive features, you know, with his neck and his shoulders, and, you know, he's got a big size head, but his neck's so much more thicker that it takes away from the head. But, you know, all around, he's just an extreme exotic. When I mean exotic, on the look too, as well as he's not the everyday type of brindle. He's more of a, I would say like a marble type of dog, you know. I've accomplished a lot with Don Julio so far, and he's a youngster. He's only 3 years old, but I've won best in shows, first ever ABKC Extreme Champ. Foundation female is a direct Monster Moo Moo daughter. Moo's the blood, as we all know, Ace and Blackjack 21 and so forth, sister. She's a foundation female, made some very nice dogs. Directly with Monster Moo Moo, I would say is one of probably the most impressive breedings of a decade. And they've also produced some of the most unique dogs. For instance, One Drop, Conan She-Devil. You know, Mojo's sister, my female's Mojo, came out to be some of the most extreme and exotic looking pit bulls. As we all know, we all have Don Julio here at MPK, repping Don Line to the fullest. You know what I mean? He's making some of the top-notch hitters out there, dog. Like, I got one, for example, Don King. Here we go. He's a freak, man. You guys just keep an eye out for this boy. He's coming out hard. Don King's off of our foundation bitch, Mojo. Mojo's a direct Monster Moo Moo female, so you can imagine that pedigree. We also brought out Moo Moo. Moo Moo's also a foundation female. She's off of our MPK's Mojo as well, Don Julio Mojo. And bred together, those make some of the most extreme puppies out to date. Don Grizzly is a little pup off of Don Julio and Sweet and Low. She's off of our female Mojo as well, our foundation female. She was bred to Don Julio and had this beautiful pup. His name is Grizzly, like I said, Don Grizzly. You guys keep that name going in your heads, because it's going to be ringing out there one day. And here we go with, I call her No Fair. The reason to be at No Fair, because she's just No Fair. When she walks, she waddles. Donna Black's, this little pup right here, is just going to be something crazy, you know? As far as Mini Mocha goes, right here, the little red nose, little female right here. She's actually not a red nose, she's a blue nose, but she came out with this one of a kind color, you know what I mean? Just to go with our exotic look, you know what I mean? had to bring her into the game. She's a little different. She's got her own little personality. And of course, this blue one that we made right here, this is one of the ones we made for show. She was bred to a 21 blackjack daughter to make something this clean. This is Donna Mama. Another one was Mini Mocha. Hey, thank you guys for stopping here at Monster Pit Kennels. MPK, Gotti Lions MPK. So that's the website, www.gottilionsmpk.com. You've been with us, you've seen us. If you guys know what we're doing, short, wide, thick, and bully. If you guys are down with it, you know what I mean? Check us out, hit us up. We do easy business, we do everything easy.
Hey, thank you for coming. This is Rick with Costa Nostra Bullies. Today I want to show you what I have in my yard. You're gonna see some good males, some good ass females. This is my boy right here, King Gotti. Check him out. All right, we checked out our badass boy, King Gotti. His head is 26 inches and 90 pounds. He's 16 and a half inches tall. You can check out my boy right here, Bentley. His mom and dad, they're both out of Gotti. He has a 23 inch head. He's 17 inches tall, weighing 80 pounds. All right, now that you saw our boy Bentley, check out our female right here. Her name is Blue Magic. She's out of Legend. And Carmela, she's 2 years. I believe she's 2 years. I'm not really sure. But look at her. She has produced some of some nice little boys right now that we have, and some that we ship to Arizona, and they stay here local in San Diego. This is her puppy right here at 3 months. He's out of King Gotti and Blue Magic, and this is one of the little samples. Well, this is our badass female that produces right here. All right, this is right now you saw our female Blue Magic, and you see what she produced. Now let me show you Cookies right here. This girl right here, she's out of a Backyard Boogie and Queen Lunatic. That's Legend's litter mate sister. And right now we have a nice badass litter right now. This puppies right here, they recently turned 4 weeks old. So right now they're five out of the litter. Three of them are sold already. We only have two up for grabs, which are these two right here, this little pocket one right here. And we have this one up for grabs, you know, but we have litters going on all the time, all year round. If you're interested, you could hit us up at CosaNostraBullies.com. All right, now that you saw one of our baddest females, check out another one that we have right here on site. This is Carmela. Her dad is Simbra. He's out of Notorious Juan Gotti. And her mom is Talula, straight out of Granddaughter of Monster. Come on, girl. Good girl. All right, my boy King Gotti, you know, ever since I saw him, he was a very impressed puppy ever since I saw him. I got him when he was a month and a half. and it's a funny story because I was not even in the market to buy a dog. I already had three dogs. And my wife, she saw him and she fell in love with him. She like, oh baby, please buy him, because he was adorable. He looked like a little polar bear, you know, like a little bear. So all my kids, they were like, come on, let's buy him. I'm like, all right, whatever, you know. And now from now on, every time I choose a dog, I don't choose the dogs. My wife does it because obviously she's the one that has an eye for it. We went to the San Diego show. I'm starting to put him on the Extreme Bully because on the ABKC, there's two competitions. There's Standard and there's Extreme. And I noticed that when I would be putting him in Standard, he would not be doing good. He would not place. So I started putting him Extreme and he started doing real good. He took first place male. He took best in show. Actually, you know what? I apologize. He took best male in show and his son, Carlos Gambino, he's the one that took best in show in the San Diego show. 4th of July, people ask me like, why do I put King Gotti on Remy? You know, first his name is King Gotti. King Gotti, he's 60-40. He's 60 Gotti and 40% Remy, Raiser's Edge. He's Remy certified. You know, we went to the show up north. I believe it was Kingsburg. Kingsburg and Remy was there. Remy Line was there. Fabian was there. Ever since Fabian saw King Gotti, I think, right? I don't know if he's BSing me, but he loves King Gotti. He loves him a lot. He likes him a lot. You know, he's very proud that King Gotti has that Remy blood in him. So right away, he certified him. I got my certificate on mail. So every time there's a Remy show, the Remy line, it's at the shows, I try to put them in. You know, I'm very fortunate to put him on Remy. I'm very fortunate to put him on Razor's Edge, and I'm very fortunate to put him on Gotti. So he has the best bloods out there. So he could go in different competitions. He could go in Gotti competition, he could go in Remy, he could go to Razor's Edge. And so far, I have put him in two competitions. On Kingsburg, he took second place, and on the 4th of July, he took first place.
Thank you, bro. Thank you.
1 to 2 year female!
But right now, my boy, King Gotti, he's a year and a half. He's making a big name for himself. His productions, the way he looks, how the way in the ring turned out to be a very beautiful dog. He has like 7 more months to get more thicker. And I believe that he has not done yet with his legacy. I'm pretty sure that his grandkids, his kids, they're gonna turn out to be some beautiful dogs. If you're interested in King Gotti, you know, he's a good producer. I'm not shy about putting his productions out there. We're starting them out right now for $2,000. We started off at $1,000, and then we bumped it up to $2,000. A lot of people ask me, like, why his stud fees, they keep bumping them up. What does that consist on? And it consists on his productions. You know, the better dogs, the better quality dogs, the puppies he's been throwing out there, the better his stud is gonna go up. You know, there's some stud services out there for some dogs that they're $5,000, $10,000. You know, is it worth it? To me, it is. You know, it's a matter of what you're looking for. If you're looking for some beautiful dogs, you know, you're gonna pay extra more. If you're looking for some average dogs, you're gonna pay less. You know, like what they say, you get what you pay. If you want some nice looking, beautiful dogs with nice blocky head, nice chest, compact, hit me up, go to my website, piratekennel.com, or you could check it out, CosaNostraBullies.com.
Hey, what's going on, y'all? This is Dante at American Pitbull Kennels. I'm over here at one of our main facilities right here, as you can see in the back. Basically, what we do here is we produce some of the finest pit bulls that San Diego has to offer. I met my partner Diego, which is the founder of American Pitbull Kennels. He basically introduced me into the breeding game. So we hit it off ever since then, and you know, trying to get good business going. All right, so I'm gonna take you on a little tour of what we got going on in the kennel. Show you a couple of the finer ones we produced. And let me introduce you over here to Junior over here. He's one of our prized possessions, son of Monster. He's about 14 months, excuse me. 85% Razor's Edge, 15% Nevada. He's 85% Razor's Edge, 15% Gotti Line. And he's at 98 pounds at about 2.5 years, about to be 3. All right here we got Yunam. She's 100% Nemesis, roughly about 96 pounds right now, 2.5 years old. With that said and done, let me get you over to the founder, Diego, and his son, Carlos.
Hello, everybody. My name is Carlos Garcia. This is my father, Diego Garcia, and we are from American Pitbull Kennels. The bloodlines that we're using are Nevada, Gotti Line, and Razor Edge. We first started off with a red nose pit bull, and then we moved on to blue line. And from blue line, we're trying to move on to bullies. And basically what we're trying to do bullies is because they're very lovable, they're kid friendly, and they're not only our best friends, but they're also part of the family. We have 10 bullies in our kennel, but today I'm only gonna show you 4. Our first dog, Rush, he's actually my dog. I named him Rush because he's just like a shot of adrenaline rush. He's just crazy, he's active, he loves kids and everything, he's just out there. He's 85% Razor Edge and 15% Nevada. He really loves that treadmill, he just gets on, like as you've seen in the video, he just gets on and he does his thing, he likes to exercise, he loves that thing, and he could be there for hours. Our second dog, Chingon, he's 11 months. And he's also 85% Razor Edge and 15% Nevada. And he's a really sweet dog as well. He doesn't really like the treadmill, but he loves to run around and just do his thing. Our next dog is Chata. She's 2 years old. She's 50% Butterhead and 50% Gaudy Line as well. And she's actually, her father is Geronimo from Travis Pitts. Chata, she's, whenever we go to a community show or anything like that, she's a crowd favorite. She takes around 25 to 40 pictures, and she's a crowd pleaser. Our next dog is Shorty. She is 11 months, and she's already 96 pounds. She is 50% Nemesis and 50% Gaudy Line. This is Carlos Garcia and Diego Garcia from American Pitbull Kennels. Well, we hope that you had a great time, and thank you for stopping by at American Pitbull Kennels, and hope to see you around the show.
It turned out to be a really great day. The weather was nice. It was supposed to rain this morning. We had a little overcast, but it's clear, kind of a little cloudy. Man, a great turnout, great people. A lot of different kennels, new people that have been doing it for a while. Man, it was a great turnout. Barbecues going. Just a lot of, you know, a lot of nice dogs, good people. And if anybody's interested in shows or events and want to get into this, you can go to bullyshows.com and find your local event. Or if you're wanting to be a show host or get involved with the ABKC, you can go on bullyshows.com or even abkcdogs.org, you know, and check out the site and get involved, you know.
What's up, how you doing today? This is Damiano right here with Bully League. We're out here representing. We got a t-shirt company right here, Bully League. It started off as a t-shirt company. My background is more into the events, so we're combining a t-shirt company with the events, and lo and behold, working with Yukonuba, we saw the need to open up a pet food store called Bully League Pet Nutrition Center. And so we got it in Fontana, California. That's right, the address is 10557 Juniper Avenue. Come check us out. The first Bully League, the Bully dog pet food company of its kind for the Bully community. So come check us out. Also, we're dropping the Bully League Classifieds. That's right, it's gonna be a free magazine that's gonna go to everybody in the community, and it's gonna help the, basically a distribution system for people to get their studs known out there, you know, whether they got their kennel club, blow it up, whatever it is you want to do, we can help you distribute. That's the whole thing that Bully League is. We're a distribution powerhouse. So whether it's a t-shirt, whether it's an event, whether it's a magazine or pet food, Bully League is where it's at. That's right, we're a distribution powerhouse, and we're here for the bully scene.
Hi, my name is Luciano Aguilar, and I'm from Sit Mean Sit Los Angeles Dog Training. We specialize in basically building the focus in the dog, and then from there being able to do exactly what it is you want us to do. We can take your dog all the way from just plain simple obedience all the way on up to trick training and you know, customize it for you. So if you guys want a dog that is super well trained, listens to you and does everything out of love and respect, you know, please give us a call. We'll give you a free evaluation. Just mention this video and we'll be more than happy to help you guys out. Our number is 310-538-1553. And you guys can actually visit us online and check out our many videos at www.sitmeansit.com. Again, I'm Luciano from Sit Means Sit.
Say, man, what y'all doing over here, man?
Man, what the hell you mean what y'all doing over here?
Hey, man, get y'all ass off my field, man. Hey, hold on, man. Don't walk up to me, man. Stay back. Hey, hold on, man. Hold on, man. Don't walk up on me, man. Hey, man, back up, man. Back up, partner. Hold on. Watch. Yay! Hiya, hiya, watch it, boy. Hiya. Good boy. Good boy. Chop up. Oh. Yay. Hiya. Good boy. Freeze. Up. Here.
Hey, how you doing? I'm Jeff from Master K9, Los Angeles, California. This is my man Malcolm, head trainer, Master K9. Down here, we do a lot of training, basic obedience, advanced obedience, personal protection.
What we mainly do here is customize the dog for you. My lifestyle and your lifestyle is different. You have to tell us what some of your fears are or what you need the dog to do. We test the dog, and then if the dog has it any, we customize the dog for you.
Good boy. Squat. Good boy.
We have an excellent obedience course. Anything from beginning obedience to advanced obedience. We take personal time to teach you the correct way to handle the dog. In our obedience courses, the dogs are very well socialized. There'll be no aggression. We tolerate no aggression on our field towards another animal.
Good boy. Heel. Focus. Good boy. Heel. Good boy. Focus. Good boy. Squat. Good boy. And everything is praised with the dog.
During our obedience course, we can teach your dog to stand, to take certain poses. When you give him a command, you won't have to tell him 3-4 times to do this certain command. We'll guarantee one time the dog will obey.
We have your dog ready for the show to where he's not aggressive towards other dogs. Sit at your command when you don't have to tell him more than once. The judges look for this at these shows. They make sure that the dog has good posture. And like I said again, which is very important, that the dog is not dog aggressive, because they're very close to other dogs. It can be dog aggressive. The judges look for that. These bullies are very good breed of dogs. A lot of people just keep them tied up in their backyard, keep them locked up in cages, but they're working dogs. We encourage you guys, bring them dogs down to Master K9. We have a facility here, as you will see, where we have obstacle courses. Bring them, let them run obstacles, let the dog be the dog.
Usually a pit, even your fighting pits, are not aggressive toward people. You know, kids can go right up to them and play with them. They're only aggressive against another animal. If you raise a pit right, he's just like any other dog. My daughter was raised with a pit that slept up under her bed. Never had any problems. This dog, you know, my daughter pulled this dog's ears, bit the dog's tail. The dog never was aggressive against her. I train pits every day. I'm not prejudiced against a pit. A pit took my end of my finger off, and still I train them every day. You know, I didn't blame the pit for this. This was my fault. You know, you can't blame the animal, you blame the owner. It's what man makes him.
Yeah, once again, thanks for coming visiting us down here at LA's Master K9. If you have any questions, you can contact me, Jeff, 323-822-6028. You can contact Malcolm, which is the head trainer, at area code 323-392-9577. Or you can look us up on the website, lasmasterk9.com.
All right, welcome everybody. This is Ray Certified, Gardena, California. We at the CPA, which stands for Certified Breeders Association. It's a lovely day in May. I'm gonna show you around my yard. This is a blind Gotti, about a between two and three year old blue blind male. This is like a 6 month old blue fine male. This is a little extra ill, little blue fine male, about the same age, 2-3 years old. This is about a 6 month old little blue blind female. You can't really see back there. These like some little miniature pits here. I don't know what's going on with them, but they like 6-7 months old right now. This is a blue female here, like 6 months old. This is a brother to this dog, 6 month old female, male actually. This is a, come here, boo. This is about a 3 or 4 year old female out of this one here. This is pretty much the oldest dog I got in my yard right now. This is Danger, about a 10 year old female. Come here, mom. Come on, let's go. Let's off some of my foundation stuff. Go in the house. This Fubu, this is about a 3-4 year old female. Sit down. Take some of these out. Don't go out the gate. I'll bring out Ill Silver, which is my main stud dog. Just stay there, I'll bring him out. Office at the CPBA, and what I'm gonna do now is take you to my website, which is thebluebomb.com, www.thebluebomb.com. These are some of my celebrity clients. That's Shaquille O'Neal, that's Lorenz Tate, that's Big Dane and Snoop Dogg. Big Dane is my promotion manager. This gentleman started an organization called Canine for the Combat Wounded while he was still in the service in Germany. And he sustained some injuries in Iraq. And some people bought some dogs in, therapy dogs in Germany. And they were the only things that he responded to. So he went and got a contract with the Army. And the Army researched everybody in the world and came up with me for my dogs to use as therapy dogs. And this is the actual first dog that they gave to a service, a wounded service member. And there's a picture of my dog trainer, Larry Hill, myself, Sergeant Patillo, Big Dane. And he was the first recipient of the Army's Canine for the Combat Wounded. This gentleman here, 18 years old, was in Iraq for 1 day and got his legs cut off. He turned 18 one day, went to Iraq the next day, and the very next day he got his legs cut off completely at the thigh there. And we provided them with the first therapy dog. So that goes into the reputation of this blood, and that's kind of what I warranty when I sell a dog. That goes into that was presented to me by Chavez Pitts probably about 2 or 3 months ago. I just wanted to thank them. I really appreciate it. It was a big honor. And, you know, it was, you know, just something I would like to say thank you for everybody, you know, because everybody always showed me a lot of love, and I just want to try to
you know, let everybody know I appreciate their efforts and so forth. All right, this race certified, and we're going to close it out here. I appreciate the time, and I hope everybody is able to enjoy this little presentation. All right.